Welcome everybody to the PWD podcast. This is the professor, Rick Del Santo, and joining me two very special guests. First, I'd like to introduce the return of the Guardian of Chaos, Big Daddy. What's going on, sir? And we have young, the prodigy, Tommy Sabin. What's happening, sir?
What's going on? Thanks for having me.
It's great to be back with you, Professor. I know we have a lot of breaking and trending news here on the PWZ. Go ahead, Professor. Let's see what we got coming up this weekend.
Gigantic show for Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling. Their debut on Fight TV. The biggest show so far this year. Pay-per-view. $9.99. Rumble in Paradise. It's going to be a tremendous show. What a card they have in store for us this week.
Well, I'm going to say this, Professor. It's going to be the debut for Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling. Now, yep. I don't have to explain to the fans the Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling Group. It's four men that worked under the guidance of Vincent Kennedy McMahon and in WCW. We know who they are. We know the name on the marquee is Pretty Paul Roma, Mario Mancini, Big Dave Paradise, and Paul Perez. It doesn't get any better than that. And they present Rumble in Paradise. And as you said, Professor, it's going to be live. It's on Fight TV. It's going to be the event of the weekend this Saturday night. And I'm proud to introduce my tag team partner on the debut for Fight TV at Paradise Alley. And that would be one talking Tommy Sabin. Tommy, welcome to the program. Give me your thoughts as an insider to PAPW. And maybe we can run through the lineup with the help of the professor. And I'm going to sit back and see what my broadcast partner has to say with perhaps the most memorable historian in this New England Northeast area, Professor Rick Del Santo.
Well, thank you for that intro, Big Daddy. And let me just say to the fans that, you know, this is, like we said, it is a huge event for PAPW. And, you know, a little insight on PAPW, we're a big family, you know, and we love putting on shows for our fans. And Paul Roma, Mario Mancini, Big Dave Paradise, Paul Perez, we are all about the fans. And we love having the kids there. They always have a great time. You know, they're so into it at our shows. And it just shows how incredible. And I mean, I can't even get into it on how awesome PAPW is and how much they've done for their fans, giving the fans what they want. And this is, I mean, I am super excited for this show, you know, much like the fans, but like the opportunities that I'm getting broadcasting this event with the Guardian of Chaos. I mean, on Fight TV, I mean, it can't get any better than that. I mean, the wrestlers that are going to be there. I mean, you know, we've got the tag champs, the House of Pain are going to be there. Matias, the heavyweight champ. You've got the Battle Academy, led by their mentor, Alley Fights champ, Red Lion, Chris Battle. Don't forget MLW star Richard Holiday. And, I mean, fan favorite, Dustin Flash Waller. Intercontinental champ, Kylon King. So many more. I mean, the list goes on and on. It's an event that you just can't miss. I said earlier the other night, I was talking with Paul Roma and Mario Mancini, and we were telling the fans that, listen, if you got plans this Saturday night, I suggest you cancel them because I've got a much better idea for you. Either get your ass to the JCC in Woodbridge, Connecticut, buy a ticket, get yourself a chair, or better yet, if you want to relax on your couch at home, that's fine. $9.99, that's it. That's all you got to do. Get your popcorn. Whatever you want to do and enjoy a night of pro wrestling. Look, you know, this past weekend was a big weekend for pro wrestling. You had SummerSlam Saturday night, NXT TakeOver on Sunday. But guess what? WWE, their weekend is over. Now this weekend, it's PAPW's turn to shine bright.
Wow. I think you just did our job for us. It's we still have a whole hour left. But, you know, you announced everything. everything that is going to happen.
Well,
this
that's
week.
About it on PWC. Maybe we could wrap it up, Professor. That's why they call him Talkin Tommy Sabin. He just broke it down. Unbelievable. Now, Professor, it's great to be back on PWZ. And again, Tommy's talking about what's going to happen this Saturday night live at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And that would be Rumble in Paradise. Now, Professor, I'm going to give it over to you. Let's break down the lineup, and then maybe we can go into the Rumble itself. Tommy, feel free. After you just blew us away with that opening monologue, I could see why maybe Prodigy, but I think I'm a little partial to Talkin' Tommy. What do you think, Professor?
I think that's a great one. I think it's a good nickname. As soon as you said it, I said, that's it. That's the name.
I was thinking the same thing.
It just happens, Talkin' Tommy. Double T, if you will.
Just like that.
Professor, so again, I want to give it to you because you are an insider for Paradise Alley. You are there filming the matches. You put it out on the podcast. What you do for Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling is second to none. There's a lot of people out there that are in the broadcast journalism and podcast industry, in the IWC, if you will. And Professor, what you do for PAPW is valued as an insider. And rumor has it that you may even be a part of the broadcast team in the very near future for Paradise Alley. Your thoughts on the Rumble in Paradise? And I'm going to sit back because I got to hear Talkin Tommy and the Professor.
I am looking forward to that. That is true. And you know, it's going to be a really great show. Matias takes on Richard Holiday. That's going to be a big, 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 big match right there for Paradise Alley, the World Heavyweight Championship. Excuse me, gentlemen. That's going to be one of the highlight matches for the entire evening.
Right now, there. I want to
a lot of history there between those two.
There's a ton of history between those two, Professor, and that's very well said. We know that Richard Holiday was the first premier student at Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling. We know that he is a current MLW superstar. We know that he was and still is, if I'm not mistaken, and maybe Talkin' Tommy can correct me, the Caribbean heavyweight champion, or maybe even the WWC or IWA Puerto Rican
it's
champion.
IWA, right now. Yep.
See, Talkin' Tommy, help me out with this one. The main event, Richard Holiday and the Uruguayan sensation, Matias DiNapoli.
You know, this is, you know, forgive me, I might be a little biased here, but this is one of the matches I think I'm most looking forward to. Obviously, the Rumble, you know, what's a Rumble event without a Rumble itself? So I'm super excited for the Rumble. You don't know what to expect, but this is a match because, in my opinion, this could go down as one of the biggest matches in PAPW history. Two of the top talents that PAPW has ever seen. Two good friends. Don't forget that. Matias and Richard Holiday, yes, they've had their history, but they've put that aside, and they have become great friends. A couple months ago, PAPW fans might remember, they actually teamed up at Friday Night Alley Fights to take on Elijah Six and Sammy Diaz, and they came away victorious. And it's incredible the chemistry that they have built up. So the big question that myself, I'm sure Big Daddy and the Professor could agree, and I think the fans probably want to know, how in the world are these two going to put their friendship aside for the greatest prize in PAPW? That's the big question.
Professor?
That's a really good question. I don't know how they're going to do it. Either way, they're going to go in there, and I'm sure it's going to be a five-star matchup. I really do. These two performers are phenomenal in the ring. Richard Holiday is, I've always said this, he's made for TV. I've said this many times. He's ready to be that star. And I think that, you know, him adding another Paradise Alley title win to his notch could bring him there.
Well, I will say this for sure. When it comes to this Saturday Night Live on Fight TV, we're all going to be breathing rarefied air inside the JCC when Richard Holiday takes on Matias DiNapoli. Again, it's for the heavyweight championship in PAPW. Both men have been champion in Paradise Alley, obviously.
Yep.
What I want to ask next is the three-time defending tag team champions, their house, their rules, Nick Payne, Hakim Ali, the House of Payne, taking on recently seen in AEW, and that would be Waves and Curls. I'm going to go to the professor first, and then Talkin' Tommy, maybe you could jump in on what's to be perhaps one of the best tag team matchups in PAPW history.
This match right here. Now, if you remember, and I brought this up last the other day when I was talking to Matt DeCourt, you remember Unchained? The event just last year, right? The last show before the pandemic.
The Hercules Hernandez Memorial Tournament.
Waves and Curls thought they had that title win. Nick Payne's foot was underneath the ropes. Until the second referee, L-Ref, came out and informed the Ref Bill that there couldn't be a pinfall because of that. And then Nick Payne and they ended up coming up from behind and pinning Schoolboying the Waves and Curls.
Say that Waves, three times back.
I know, right? I just got confused. Schoolboying Waves and Curls and taking that win and walking away with their own titles that night. They haven't lost those titles since. These guys, this is a rematch that has been brewing for over a year. And I think this is going to be one of those matches that it's just going to be a phenomenal match that evening. It's going to be one of those matches. It's just going to be a really great tag team match, and there's a lot on the line for this match.
Yeah, I agree. You know, Waves and Curls, I think, have been a very, very popular team in PAPW. Absolutely. I mean, their music just gets you going. I mean, I remember they used to come out to Whitney Houston, and I mean, everyone went nuts.
Baby.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I mean, I, you know, the fan in me just took over my whole body. I was like, I wanted to dance with somebody because it's literally exactly, you know, and they get the crowd going. They really have
they sure do.
So much energy. They really attract the audience. They get the fans fired up for their match. The House of Pain, you know, whether you love them or hate them, you have to give credit where it's due. They have been one of the best tag teams we've ever seen in PAPW. One of the most dominant, you know.
Well, I would dare say, Talkin' Tommy, double T, if you will, I would dare say the best tag team in PAPW history. And I say that. They've been champions now for over 400 days. This is their third title reign. They've run roughshod over everybody in PAPW for the last 3 or 4 years, and they also hold titles in other organizations and other territories. Now, what more can these two gentlemen, and I'll use that term loosely when it comes to the HOP, what more can they accomplish in Waves and Curls? Let's be honest, Double T, Professor, they were just in AEW on Dark. I know you guys saw it. Break this down. Before we get out of here, yeah. I want a prediction on this match.
Oh, man. You know, I really think the House of Pain would kill me if I said anything more than Waves and Curls would leave with the titles. Big Daddy, are you still with us?
Yes, I'm actually okay. Receiving a call right okay. Now from head trainer, one Pretty Paul Roma, and he's not going to be happy when he sees this. I'm going to have to decline that call.
And
can you believe, am I back? Am I
yeah,
back?
There you are.
Can you believe that we are live to tape right now on PWZ with the Professor Rick Del Santo and Double T Talkin' Tommy Sabin and yours truly, the GOC. It's me. And I just got a phone call from head trainer who will be on Fight TV this weekend. And you've seen the vignettes. You've seen the promos. Talkin' Tommy, you were right there. Is the conjecture has been, seeing that I have the inside scoop on what's going to happen on Fight TV this weekend, Roma just called me. I don't have to read the lineage. You already know it. Tommy, you did the promo with Mario Mancini and Paul Roma. Roma is still jacked, ripped, buff. He's like shredded wheat. Is he going to sign the contract? Is he going to be in the Rumble?
I got to tell you, Big Daddy, standing next to Pretty Paul Roma, seeing him in that muscle shirt getting all jacked up, his biceps were bigger than my whole head, Big Daddy. I mean, whether he signs a contract or not, I don't know if I could say no to the guy without him squeezing my head. I feel like if I were to say, sorry, Roma, but you gotta sign the contract. You can't be in the Rumble. I think he's gonna squeeze my head.
Well, let me reconfirm that for you, Double T. He will pop it like a grape or like a pimple. But what I want to know, and this is why everyone's going to be tuning in, and Professor, I want to drag you into this conversation. Tommy, you were there. Roma looks tremendous. Mario's been trying to chase him. Professor, I'm going to throw it over to you, even though it's your show, PWZ, covering Fight TV, Rumble in Paradise this Saturday on Fight TV. Will Roma step into the ring? Will he get clearance? First off, he looks like he's in great shape. And what will that mean to the rest of the competitors in the Rumble in Paradise? Professor, can you step in before the prodigy takes over?
I would love to see Roma jump in. And I'm going to tell you, it's been no secret that Roma's been one of my favorite wrestlers since I was a kid. Since, I don't know, 1986, 1987? That's the actual truth. I always thought he was one of those competitors that, you know, he had the great future. He was a phenomenal wrestler, and I cannot wait. And I'm really hoping he jumps in there. Even if it's for a minute, I will pop. Me sitting back there in a chair, I'm going to pop. I really will.
Now, Tommy, could you imagine if Roma does get into this Rumble in Paradise and then makes that incredible, nimble like a minx, one leap to the top rope and drops that 20-foot elbow onto one of the competitors, maybe even Mario Mancini?
You know, Big Daddy, the only thing that's going through my mind about Pretty Paul Roma entering the Rumble is I'm more concerned about the other wrestlers. Because that's their trainer. If they throw Roma out, what's it going to look like next time they're going to training?
But can anybody throw Paul Roma out, Tommy? Can anybody throw Roma out?
That's a good point.
Listen, it's a small word, and it's got a large meaning. The word if. If Pretty Paul Roma enters Rumble in Paradise. And the only reason why we jump ahead, it's because I got a phone call from the man himself. And Tommy, Professor, that may have been the call to tell me, hey, listen, Big Daddy, Chaos, let him know right now live on PWZ, live to tape, that I am going to enter the Rumble. I don't know what Roma wants. Can somebody inbox him? Is somebody going to call him? Should we get him on the air?
Listen, but the thing is, this is just a sign to all of you fans, you PAPW fans, that this – By the pay-per-view, you need to be there August 28th, because if you want to see Roma in the Rumble, we don't know if he is. Roma could be in it. Roma might not. We don't know. If you want to find out, you need to be there August 28th.
Rick, and I apologize, Professor.
Nope, you're
because
good.
We're talking about the head trainer at Paradise Alley, and we weren't going to jump right into the competitors in the Rumble yet, according to Rick's a format here. We're going to cover the card. But not only did Roma call us, Mario Mancini, Professor, I'm going to give it to you before I give it to Talkin' Tommy. Mario Mancini, 84 to 92 in the WWF, one of the top three jobbers of all time in World Wrestling Federation Wrestling Entertainment history, top 10 in all of professional wrestling voted by SiriusXM and you, the fans. The owner of Paradise Alley is getting back into the ring. He's got scores to settle. Is Mancini in the best shape of his life, Professor? Tommy, I'll leave it to you two to debate Mario Mancini's entrance into Rumble in Paradise this Saturday night live on Fight TV.
Mario's looking awesome. He's moving around a lot better than he has probably in a number of years. I'm really looking forward to seeing him in that ring. Who's he going to take out? Who is he going to go straight for in the Rumble once he steps in there?
You know, I got to tell you, though, with Mario Mancini, I think where he has a huge advantage is experience. He has almost 40
Absolutely.
Years experience in this business. I think 37, correct me if I'm wrong, it's around
I think 40s. You're right, Talkin' Tommy.
I think
something like that. He has the experience. So he's been in all different types of matches that some of these guys, this might be their first over-the-top Rumble match in their wrestling careers. Mario Mancini has the experience. It's much like for the fans that have watched the WWE Royal Rumble pay-per-views. Sometimes the guys that have the most experience in the Rumble matches might be picked the favorites. Mario Mancini might be a favorite to pick for this matchup.
Well, I mean, I'm going to allude to that, Tommy, because the professor and I talked about it pre-show on PWZ. Mario, back in the late 80s, early 90s, was in a steel cage battle royal in the Hartford Civic Center with the likes of Don Morocco and Ken Patera and so on and so forth. So, Tommy, that's a valid point. Bringing up the experience of Mario and being in every sort of battle, not to mention stretcher matches, pre-WrestleMania 1, 2, and 3 in his career. So his experience alone, and let's not forget this, Professor alluded to it pre-show as well. He's trained virtually half of the men that are going to be in the Rumble in Paradise and Paradise's debut on Fight TV this weekend. Professor, we spoke to that. Can you talk to Mancini's age? Is he in shape? Stamina? The Young Lions? The Miracle Generation that's in this Rumble?
Some of these kids he's trained are incredible in the ring. These kids, so he's really doing a wonderful job getting in there, training these guys. You got Flash, you got Kylon, you got the Haven, all these guys.
Guys, did this you see I jumped off screen again? Are you watching?
Yes, sir.
Do you know who's calling me now? Talking Tommy, can you guess who's calling me now?
Well, Paul Roma already called you. I'm going to take a guess. It's Mario Mancini.
Okay. So there, live to tape here on PWZ as I bounce on and off the tape. Head trainer Paul Roma called me. Mario Mancini is calling me again, blowing up my phone right now to talk about what's going to happen this Saturday night on Fight TV. Do you see what's happening, guys?
Oh, he's
listen, they are trying to
get a serious phone call.
We are not going to stop. We are not. Tommy and Professor, I want you to continue as talk about the Rumble in Paradise as I try to thwart Mario Mancini.
Sure thing. Sure thing. We got the, you know, this Mario is looking great, as we were saying. That's where we left off, right? Talking about Mario. He's trained more than half of these people that are getting in there. You've got Flash, you've got Kylon, you've got the Haven. Let's see, who else? Did I mention Kylon? I think I did.
But Waller, Bull Dredd, Maxim Morozov.
Dredd, yep. All these guys that are coming in there, he is going to have, you know, how's that going to be in the ring?
Talking Tommy. Hold on, Professor. Talking Tommy. I need a favor from Talking Tommy. I'm going to put you on the spot, Talking Tommy.
Okay.
Can you please call in your dad, Mr. Sabin, who was my former broadcast partner, and tell him to text Mario we're doing a live show about Fight TV and Rumble in Paradise this weekend?
I was a little bit ahead of you, Big Daddy. I was kind of thinking, should I let the old man know?
Yes, we're doing a live show here for Fight TV. Professor, it doesn't get any bigger than that. We were talking about Sunset Steve, Elijah Six, Sammy Diaz, Bloodsong, Lucas
Mario
Chase.
On Skype? Is Mario on Skype?
Jay Rude, Zane Bernardo, he might be on Skype. Look at the people that are in the Rumble. Tommy's taking away.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be an incredible Rumble. You know, the best part about a Rumble match is the surprises, because you don't know. There's what, 30 spots?
30 people. And how many people have been listed so far? Less than a dozen?
Far,
there's going to be a lot of surprises, Tommy. Go ahead. Let's run down the lineup.
I've heard Dustin Flash Waller. I've heard the Icon Bull Dredd. Red Lion, Chris Battle, the King of Paradise, Ichiban, Maxim Morozov, the Cure, Lucas Chase, Zane Bernardo, Sammy Diaz, Buzz Bloodsaw, Zafar Al-Rahi, Showtime, Marcel Williams, Kylon King, RJ Root, Zach Gibbs. The list goes on and on. That's just a handful, and there's going to be so much more, and like I said, a lot of surprises. And the one question I want to touch on, I mentioned Showtime Marcel Williams. If PAPW fans might know, last few shows that the Alley fights, Marcel Williams has had quite the run-in with one Vlad.
Yes, the big man Vlad, the monster Vlad.
And the last time we saw Showtime Marcel Williams, the last Alley fights event, Marcel Williams picked up a nice victory, and he got on the mic and said, "Hey, Vlad, I'm right here for you, and I'm letting you know right now, August 28th, I will be at the Rumble. I will be in the Rumble, so I'm right here waiting for you." So he issued the challenge to the big man. Now the question is, will Vlad be there? That's a good question to ask. I think the fans might want to know, will Vlad be there?
Well, Vlad, as the professor knows, and Tommy yourself, the fans know this, he's the former PAPW heavyweight champion. And the feud and the bitter rivalry between Vlad and Matias DiNapoli, it was even rumored that Vlad stole DiNapoli's girl. So there's a lot of history between Vlad and what's going on. And I noticed there's a lot of heat going on in these past several shows at Paradise Alley between one Dustin Flash Waller and Showtime Marcel Williams. And even Mario Mancini has something in stake in the Rumble when it comes to Dustin Flash Waller and what's going to happen. There's a lot of heat that's going on from what I understand. We ran through the participants, the most savvy guy. If Roma and Mancini, who are the odds-on favorites, if Roma gets in the battle, it's still an if, I said that. And Mancini, I don't know. He's in the best shape of perhaps of his career. Can he hold up to all the young Lions and former stars that are in there? My odds-on favorite, Talking Tommy and Professor, is Showtime Marcel Williams in the Rumble in Paradise. He is
Big Dad's
pick for the Rumble in Paradise. Put that in your pipe and smoke that. How's that jar your preserves and let that marinate?
That's a very interesting pick. That is a very interesting pick. Wow.
Hey, I don't know anything more than Talking Tommy or the Professor. We're going to see it live on Fight TV this Saturday night. Hey, listen, it's only $10.
Actually, no.
Are you kidding me?
We'll be there in person. We'll be there in person. But I urge everybody that's listening, it's only $9.99. Hey, I know these people got fight credits.
I have that in my change jar.
You got people, yeah, right? You got, I'm sure all these people that are listening, they use fight on a frequent basis. I'm sure you have fight credits that are built up. Take those credits and buy it. $9.99. That's it. It's probably the lowest cost pay-per-view.
It's going to be
a phenomenal show. I'm saying that right now.
Let me tell you a quick story. A quick story, like less than 2 minutes. Last night I was with the PAPW crew, and I was talking with Pretty Paul Roma, and he was at the gym, and he was talking to one of his buddies, and this buddy asked him, "Hey, you got any shows coming up?" And he said, "We got one August 28th, and it's going to be on Fight TV." Really? The guy pulled out his phone. He had his Fight TV app, and he clicked on it, and he said, "Boom, I just ordered it." Really?
That's
it's
awesome.
That easy, folks.
Yep.
It's that freaking easy.
Yep. That's awesome. That's phenomenal. Because, yeah, as soon as when it was announced it was happening on Fight, okay, I looked every day until it was actually posted. Once I saw it posted, that same minute I saw it posted, I automatically clicked purchase. I said, "I'm going to be there in person." And I even bought the thing because I love Paradise Alley, and I want to support
Professor,
there's nobody like you
that does it in this industry. Not only do you present the product, you're a fan like all of us. Now, people get offended by the word mark. I'm a fan. I'm a mark.
I've been in
the ring with over 30 WWE Hall of Famers. We're all marks, and that's something to be proud of. What I would like to talk about, and I want to bring Talking Tommy back in on this, and Professor, because you're there at every show, and I know that Tommy is personal friends with some of these guys, I want to talk about the tag team matchup between the Brick City Boys and Jay Onyx and Sean Knight, The Haven. Talking Tommy, I'm going to give it to you because I know that you run with this group of guys.
Yeah, I am a big Miracle Generation guy. I love all four of those. The Haven, Flash Waller, Kylon King. Those are my guys. You know, and I
watched. Can you call it down the middle, fucking Tommy?
Absolutely.
Can you call
absolutely.
It down the middle?
I am as neutral and unbiased as it gets. Don't
as neutral as ref Bill Thompson, senior referee Bill Thompson. Are you as neutral as L. Ref or Jay Mendez or Cuba? Are you as the zebras of justice? Can you call it down the middle, talking Tommy on Fight TV?
I will call it as far down the middle as I can, Big Daddy. It'll be an incredible matchup. I'm excited for this. Brick City Boys versus The Haven. And according to my sheet, that's supposed to be kicking off the show. And that's going to be a great.
That is going to be a good opener.
To open up
wow.
The show.
I want to ask the professor this as I take the chains off here because I'm getting ready for Fight TV this Saturday night. Professor, you do your research. You do your due diligence. Can you tell the fans and the GOC personally a little bit more about the Brick City Boys? We already know the history of the former tag team champions, The Haven. Fill us in.
Brick City Boys are a young tag team coming up from New Jersey. They've been making a lot of appearances in the Northeast. A lot. They've been all over the place. The last was it Emergence. It was. They teamed up. It was The Haven against Team España. And
Jose and Hose B.
Jose and Hose B. Brick City Boys came out to seem like they were about to congratulate the Haven for their win. And they went, as soon as they helped raise Sean and Jay's arms, they turned around and attacked them. So there's a score to be settled here. The Haven are looking to get revenge on these boys. This is going to be a barn burner. I'm telling you right now, it's going to be such a great opener. It'll be a phenomenal match. I guarantee. And I'm taking The Haven on this one.
Talking Tommy, take it away.
You know, the professor kind of, you know, he said it all. You know, the Brick City Boys versus The Haven. You know, The Haven, they've got a score to settle with the Brick City Boys. They are looking for some vengeance after being viciously attacked. The Brick City Boys, you know, haven't been around in PAPW as often, but they are here, ready to make their mark on PAPW. And
looking forward to that. I really Haven, am.
The Haven, it's going to be a great matchup between two incredible teams, both teams who have great chemistry, and I think it's going to be, like I said, it's going to get the house warmed up really quickly. Open up Rumble in Paradise.
Speaking of the Miracle Generation, I want to bring this over to you and speculation on what's going to happen this Saturday night on Fight TV at 7 p.m. The debut of Rumble in Paradise at Paradise Alley. The Intercontinental Champion, Kylon King, has an open challenge, Professor. Can you give any speculation to the fans out there that are going to be tuning in for Fight TV and on PAPW? The roster is deep for Rumble in Paradise. We have 20 guys, 30 guys in the Rumble, some yet to be announced, potential Roma, and of course Mario Mancini. Tell me, who's going to step up and take on the Miracle Generation? And then again, we'll kick it over to Talkin' Tommy, because this, the Miracle Generation is what he is. He's a part of the Miracle Generation himself.
You know, I've really been trying hard to think who on earth is going to be, who is going to accept this challenge to Kylon King. Either way, I know it's going to be a tough fight, but I have a feeling this is live on pay-per-view. There might be a title change. It might be that big to try to kick off something good. So I'm trying to figure out who on earth this could be. It's not going to be Maxim Morozov. He just made his appearance against Kylon a couple weeks ago, right? In an open challenge.
But this is an open challenge, Professor. So I mean, it doesn't matter.
That's true. That's true, too. Does he get that many chances? Let's see. I don't know. It's really, really driving me nuts that I can't think of one person that it's going to be. Is it going to be somebody from outside the company? From outside of Paradise Alley?
Is that why Roma and Mancini called the show tonight? They called PWZ to maybe let us in? Talkin' Tommy, what do you think, seeing that you are an integral part of the Miracle Generation?
You know, this is actually something I'm excited about. And because, you know, like we said before, we talked about the Rumble match. One thing that's so exciting about a Rumble match is the surprises. You don't know what to expect. And now we've got an open challenge for the Intercontinental Championship, and we don't know who's going to answer it.
Right.
It could be anyone.
I didn't answer Mario's call again.
He's really trying to get on the show tonight.
What other podcast in the IWC will have live call-ins from WWE and WCW legends? Oh, wait. Holy Christmas. I just got some bad news. Shit.
Do we need to go?
Oh, my Lord. Guys, I got to continue on the air with this, talking to Tommy and Rick. I'm going to get off. I'm going to text you guys right away. I have to confirm this. Okay. Thank you.
Yep. Holy Christmas. All right.
Wow.
Well, hope everything's all right with Big Daddy.
I hope everything's all right with Big Daddy. I hope everything's all right with Mario. With everything there. That's wild. I'm really nervous, a little bit nervous now.
That could explain the constant phone calls. Like I said, Kylon King, issuing an open challenge, that could be very risky at times. Obviously, a lot of times there's always that champion's advantage, especially in a regular one-on-one matchup where, the title has to change hands, pinfall or submission, so Kylon King can get disqualified and get counted out and he still will be the champ. But in an open challenge, sometimes I think the odds could be 50-50 and maybe even against the champion because you don't know who's going to accept the challenge. It could be anyone. It could be someone that Kylon King has faced, numerous times and has beaten every single time. Or it could be someone that he's faced numerous times and he's lost to them every single time. We don't know. That's the excitement about an open challenge. And that's, again, another reason why if you want to see who's going to answer this challenge, you need to be there at the JCC. You need to get on Fight TV, $9.99, get this pay-per-view. Again, you can't miss this event. It's going to be a great night. And this is a matchup I'm excited about as well.
Kylon's a top performer in Paradise Alley, in the Northeast independent scene alone, you know what I mean? But in Connecticut, he's one of the best out here today. So anytime he gets in that ring, it's great. He puts on a great performance. And so I'm sure it's going to be a barn burner no matter who steps up. But it's just a matter of who is it. I can't think of anybody. I cannot think of anybody else.
Yeah, there's a whole list of guys it could be, looking at the participants in the Rumble. Hell, some of these participants in the Rumble may want to answer the challenge. They're going for a shot at a PAPW, the PAPW championship. And they may also think, hell, if I go for the Rumble to get a shot at the heavyweight title, why not I go in as Intercontinental champ? How cool would that be for some of these guys? We don't know.
Think of it this way. Maybe it would be former champion Bull Dredd.
Champ Bull Dredd. It could be, U.S. champ Zafar Al-Rahi. He may think, hey, I want to be a two-belt champ, Red Lion Chris Battle, the Alley Fights champ. He may think, I've got one shoulder that's pretty lonely right now. I want to put another belt on there.
You got to go
after it.
We're calling Big Daddy back. So hang on 1 second. We're getting him back in. He's got some breaking news. It's not good. Big Daddy, you with us? Big Daddy, you there?
Yeah. Can you guys hear me?
Yes. Yes.
I don't know. I don't know if I should say anything right now.
Shit, because this is just taking a different toll here. You okay if I say it?
I just want to say that
a good friend of ours, a very good friend. Oh my God.
Fans, I hate to do this on PWZ and stuff like that, and I'm not going to really throw out any information other than a tragedy has struck a PAPW, and there'll be more news about it. It's not going to affect what's going to go on this Saturday night on PAPW on a debut for Fight TV, but someone very close to us, someone a part of the Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling family, has passed away. And I'm not going to say anything more than that, except that this person was a very, very huge part of Paradise Alley. This is live breaking. This is not a work. I know we were talking about Fight TV, and I know we were talking about what's coming up this Saturday, you know, and the debut of Rumble in Paradise. But I was talking about the calls from Roma and from Mario and from breaking in here. And, you know, a very, very important person to Mario and a very important person to Paul Perez, and to Big Steve, and to the whole Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling family. And the news will come out. I don't want to be the one to say this because it's fresh. It's breaking. We're here on, what is this, Tuesday night? We're live to tape on Tuesday night, and this just happened. And so you can't account for these things. And if we can just carry on for a quick second, guys, and maybe wrap this up, Professor, I'll give it to you. We were talking about...
I just want to say one thing, that this person was a very close friend to all of us, and I just spoke to him 2 days ago, and I asked him about the Rumble. He said he wasn't going to be in town. This is really upsetting. Shit.
Yes,
I don't know if we should continue.
The bottom line is, this Saturday night, Fight TV, Paradise Alley Pro Wrestling, Matias DiNapoli, the champion, against Richard Holiday for the title. The tag team titles, the House of Pain against Waves and Curls. The Haven take on the Brick City Boys. Kylon King in an open challenge for the Intercontinental title. Alley Fights champion Chris Battle will be there. U.S. champion Zafar Al-Rahihi will be there. King of Paradise Ichiban. All the entrants in the Rumble, including Mario Mancini and potentially Paul Roma. All the stars. Don't miss it. I'm going to give it over to Rick and Talkin' Tommy. And just in honor, and maybe we should end this a little bit early. I'll let you take Absolutely. It over, Professor.
I just want to say thank you, everybody, for tuning in. We'll be there Saturday night. I hope to see you all there. Anybody that's, you know, if you're not going to be there in person, please check it out on Fight. Follow us on all social media, PWZ Pod on Twitter, TikTok, and Facebook. Tommy.
Talkin' Tommy, could you say something for us here, kid?
You know, just trying to stay positive here. Yeah, folks, thanks, obviously. Again, Professor, thank you for having me. And Big Dad, I can't wait for Saturday. It's going to be awesome. You and I are going to kill it and call on this action. And folks, hope to see you all there August 28th. I've been saying it constantly, but, you know, can't say it enough. August 28th, 2021, the JCC in Woodbridge, Connecticut, or obviously $9.99 on Fight TV. You know, it's PAPW Rumble in Paradise. You don't want to miss it. It's going to be in, you know, one of the biggest events in PAPW history. You just can't miss it.
Thank you, guys. Tommy, always welcome back. We'll talk to you guys soon.
Can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Well, my goodness gracious, let me tell you the news. My head's been wet with the midnight dew. I've been down on bended knee, talking to the man from Galilee. He spoke to me with a voice so sweet, I thought I heard the shuffle of angels' feet. He called my name and my heart stood still. When he said, John, go do my will. Go tell that long-tongued liar. Go and tell that midnight rider. Tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. Tell him that God's gonna cut him down. You can run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Well, you may throw your rock, hide your hand, working in the dark against your fellow man. But as sure as God made black and white, what's done in the dark will be brought to the light. You can run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar. Go and tell that midnight rider. Tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter. Tell him that God's gonna cut you down. Tell him that God's gonna cut you down. Tell him that God's gonna cut you down.